Properties of Fourier series. So x of t is any signal, it has exponential Fourier series coefficient as cn. Then in Laplace transform we have variable s, in Fourier transform we have variable j omega, and in Fourier series we will have variable jn omega 0. Okay, chalo, property number 1, time shift property. So kya hota time shift mein? Shift in one domain results into exponential multiplication in another domain. So x of t minus alpha, so this is nothing but shift in time domain. Then in exponential Fourier series, what will be effect? It will be multiplied by, the cn will be multiplied by exponential. So e raised to power j n omega 0 alpha. Here minus alpha, so here also minus alpha. Because in time shift property we have same sign, here minus alpha, so here also we have minus alpha. Then property number 2 is frequency shift property. Frequency shift, so now shift will be in the exponential Fourier series coefficient, shift will be with the exponential Fourier series. So let us say here C, instead of cn we have ca n minus alpha. Okay, so here If in one domain we have shifting, then in another domain we have exponential multiplication. So see here x of t is the signal, it is getting multiplied by exponential. So e raised to power j omega 0 alpha. Okay, by this factor if gets multiplied, our signal gets multiplied by this factor, then there is a shift. Now one important observation, that in frequency shift, exponential and shifting has opposite sign. Here plus, then here minus. Okay. Then j omega 0 alpha t. Okay. Or you can write j omega 0 t into alpha. No problem. Then third property, time scaling property. So it is very easy property. If x of t has Fourier series coefficient as cn, then x of at also has Fourier series coefficient cn. There will not be any change in case of time scaling property for the Fourier series. But what is difference between x of t and x of at? X of at is the compressed signal. So if x of t has time period t, then x of at has time period t by a, because this is the compression. Compressed means time period will be reduced. Then fourth property is differentiation in time. Fourth property of exponential Fourier series is differentiation in time. If x of t has Fourier series coefficient cn, then d by dt, that means differentiation, this is nothing but differentiation, will have Fourier series coefficient jn omega 0 times cn. So the factor is jn omega 0. Then fifth property is integration in time. So you know that integration and derivative are opposite. So when we have differentiation, the jn omega 0 n is, jn omega 0 gets multiplied to the cn. But when we have integration, this will get divided by jn omega 0. Cn will be divided by jn omega 0. And there is integration in time. So integration minus infinity to t x of t dt. It will have this type of exponential Fourier series coefficient. So this is the property number 5th. Then 6th property, convolution in time. Convolution in time. So suppose x of t is one signal, it has exponential Fourier series coefficient as cn. Another signal h of t, it has exponential Fourier series coefficient dn. Both the signal x of t and h of t has period capital T, then x of t convolution h of t has exponential Fourier series coefficient t times cn into tn. So convolution in one domain, multiplication in another domain, and it is getting multiplied by the time period. Seventh property is time reversal. So if x of t has time Fourier series coefficient cn, exponential Fourier series coefficient cn, then reversal means folding has another name, reversal. So x of minus t has exponential Fourier series coefficient c of minus n. Very simple, x of t has cn, x of minus t has c of minus n. Okay, then eighth property is Parsworth's relation. Property number eight is Parseval relation. So it is used to calculate the power. This property is used to calculate the power. So we know that power formula in unit number 1, we have learned the power formula. Power equal to 1 by t integration over 1 period t mod of x of t square dt. So this is the formula of power. So in terms of exponential Fourier series coefficient, it is given by power equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity mod of cn square. So these are the eight properties. You can pause the video. Once again, you can go through all the properties. Now you can start solving the problem. So question number one. Question is find exponential Fourier series coefficients. Okay, so for x of t minus 2, what will be exponential Fourier series coefficient? We have to choose the correct option. So this will be e raised to power minus 2 j n omega 0 minus 2 j n omega 0 into cn. Shift in one domain, exponential multiplication in another domain. Shift in time domain, then same sign. Here minus 2, then here also minus 2. Then second, e raised to power 3j omega 0 t x of t. So the signal is multiplied by exponential. So in another domain we will have shifting. So c of n plus 3 or n minus 3, it is a frequency shift. It is nothing but frequency shift. So frequency shift has opposite sign. Factor will be minus 3. Here plus 3, then here minus 3. Then third property, let us say x of t has Fourier series coefficient cn, then x of 3t has Fourier series coefficient. Answer is cn. The Fourier series coefficient does not change. I hope you have paused the video and you are also giving the answer simultaneously. Problem number 4. D square by dt square x of t has exponential Fourier series coefficient. So with d by dt we have jn omega 0, with d square by dt square we have jn omega 0 square into cn. So that gets square. So j square is minus 1, so it becomes minus n omega 0 into cn. Then one more. Suppose x of t given as 2 plus 4 e raised to power 2j omega 0 t jn j omega 0 t plus 4 e raised to power minus 2j omega 0 t. So what is value of power? Okay, so shortcut will be like, you can see the amplitudes. Power is dependent on only amplitudes, it is independent of this frequency terms. So 2 square plus 4 square plus 4 square. You will, in one line you will get the answer. So power, but if you want to solve it completely, so you need to compare with the series and get the coefficients. So constant term is nothing but the C naught. Here it is 2 j omega 0 t, that means it is a C2. C2 has amplitude 4. Then here it is minus 2 j omega 0 t, that means it is nothing but C minus 2 and its value is 4. Now power will be 2 square plus 4 square plus 4 square, that means 36 watt is the answer. So these are few examples based on properties. Thank you.